Welcome to Alpha Coding Podcast, an all-access pass to medical coding and billing pro tips that help you start your week off smarter. And now, here is your host, Toni Elhoms.
Hello, everyone, and welcome to the Alpha Coding Podcast series. I am your host, Toni Elhoms. Welcome to episode 27 of the podcast. Today is July 6th, and I hope everyone had a happy July 4th weekend. We've seen some pretty epic download numbers on the podcast, so I have to give a huge shout out to all of our listeners. I am extremely grateful for your support, so thank you for showing up week after week. Today, we're going to cover a topic that I get a lot of questions about, and that's pro tips for mastering physician communication. The key here is going to be clear and concise communication. So I'm going to give you some good tips. Before we dive into our topic, it's time for your Monday dose of positivity, the Mindset Monday tip. And it's brought to you by Contempo Coding, which is an on-demand educational resource provider created for coders by coders. They specialize in affordable coding certification prep courses to help you accelerate in your career. Right now, they're offering $100 off the Certified Risk Adjustment Coding Prep course when you order through our affiliate website. Visit our website, alphacodingexperts.com, and head over to the Deals and Discounts tab for a link to take advantage of this absolute steal of a deal. So our Mindset Monday tip is all about opening your eyes to opportunities. And the quote I want to share with you says, "Our lives are defined by opportunities, even the ones we miss." And the significance here is that so many people are blind to the opportunities that are literally hidden in plain sight. We have to train our mindset to spot these opportunities and then capitalize on the opportunities, because there's so many opportunities that are hidden in plain sight, but few people have the eyes to actually see them and then maximize those opportunities. This refers to a concept known as opportunity mastery, and this can be the main catalyst for achieving success and then maintaining that success. So don't let your inattention blindness, really being blind to the environment and all of the things around you, hold you back and prevent you from capitalizing on opportunities. So today we're going to cover my top 10 pro tips for mastering physician communication. I get asked a lot of questions related to coders having difficulty communicating with their physicians, maintaining their attention, being effective. And I've spent the last decade working one-on-one with physicians, spending countless hours training, shadowing in the clinic, as well as shadowing in the OR. So I've acquired a lot of knowledge and skills that I can help give you insight on how to be effective with your communication and be more comfortable. I've trained thousands of physicians and residents on coding and clinical documentation over my career. So this brings me to my pro tip number one: always start the conversation off on a positive note. So the chances of a physician being excited to talk to a coder, a coding educator, an auditor are going to be pretty slim, unless they've had a chance to meet you, they understand your value and what you can do to help make their life easier. So you're going to have to do some quick rapport building and credibility building. And the way to do this is to start off on a positive note, because likely a physician has been dreading this meeting. They've seen it on their schedule, their calendar, and they're just not looking forward to it. So you have to work hard to start off on a positive note. So one of my tricks is I always try to acknowledge their time, thank them for showing up to the meeting, giving them some type of positive feedback about their clinical documentation, because then that lets them know I've already done my homework, I've come prepared, I know what their documentation looks like and how I can best advise them on how to streamline the process, but also to be compliant and to maximize the opportunity within their documentation. So when you start off on that note, it really goes a long way in terms of building rapport and establishing your credibility. Pro tip number two: practice empathy. So you really have to put yourself in their shoes. They're working 15, 20 hour days a week, and this can really wear and tear on you. I have spent a lot of time actually shadowing providers in clinic. I've also spent time in cases like spine surgeries, anterior and posterior lumbar fusions. I've seen cardiothoracic surgery. Some of the things that these physicians and surgeons do, it's just unbelievable. So really put yourself in their shoes. They're oftentimes very exhausted. exhausted, they're overworked, they're constantly interrupted, they're always in a situation where they're being pulled in a million different directions, and that can be very taxing. Think about if you have to talk to 30 people in one day on the phone. A lot of us work in an administrative environment, so we're on the phone, we're on Zoom calls a lot. Think about how you feel after you've talked to 20 to 30 people in one day. You're completely exhausted. Now think about how a physician feels after they've been seeing these patients all day long, and everybody wants something from you. Everybody wants to feel like you're giving them something that makes them feel whole and healthy. That's what physicians feel day in and day out, and that's incredibly taxing. So you really have to stop and put yourself in their shoes. And sometimes when they have an opportunity to vent, you just have to let them vent. I can't tell you how many meetings I've had with physicians where I do very little talking because they just need to vent and get things off their chest. Once I allow them to do that, then I'm able to be more effective in my message and the information that I need to share with them. So it's really important that you practice empathy and really understand that it's not personal. It's that they're being pushed to their limits, and sometimes they just need a friendly ear, and that's okay. There's a human element to all of this, and you really want to be cognizant of that. So practicing empathy will set you apart from the rest. Pro tip number 3, understand the physician compensation structure in the organization. This is going to be really important because this is going to be a huge factor in everything that you discuss with the physician. This is what they're going to be thinking about when you're talking about codes. They're going to be thinking about work RVUs or how is this going to directly impact my paycheck. So there's typically 2 ways that physicians get paid, either based on a fixed salary or based on a work RVU compensation model. They may have bonus incentives, citizenship requirements. There's a lot of complexity with regards to physician compensation, but you want to understand what that structure is in the organization that you're working with, because this is directly tied to the physician's paycheck. So when you talk about the difference between a 99213 versus a 99214, in their mind, they're not thinking about necessarily the clinical documentation and the codes per se, but they're thinking about the work RVUs that are attached to each of those codes, because then their work RVUs are added up to a fixed dollar amount, and that dollar amount times each work RVU determines how much they get paid. This is a fundamental element to understand, because then you can reverse engineer all of the thought process based on what that compensation structure is. Pro tip number 4, your approach is everything. You're there to help them streamline their workflow and make sure that they're compliant. You're not there to add to the chaos or make them feel more overwhelmed. And you want to make sure that everything that you say really speaks to that message. That's going to help them feel more comfortable and more at ease with the whole situation. So I like to position myself as the calm in the storm. And I like to always come prepared, organized, and really adaptive to the environment, because you just never know what you're going to walk into with a physician. I could tell you so many stories. I've been on airplanes, I've been in cars, I've been in lunchrooms, in basements, in physicians' homes. You have to meet people where they're at. And sometimes that's the only block of time that they have available with their extremely busy lifestyles. So you really want to come prepared, focused, and have the ability to articulate your message in a concise and focused format. Pro tip number 5, exude confidence. So it's important that you're confident in your knowledge. You have sources to back up everything that you're saying, and you can easily provide those sources. One of my favorite things to do when I get into a heated debate with a physician is actually pull out the Medicare reference where the language is verbatim, because I've already anticipated that I'm going to get pushback about a certain subject. So you really want to anticipate their questions and areas that might have some misconception that needs to be clarified. So you want to be assertive when necessary, but you don't want to be condescending or combative, because that's not going to be effective at all. Pro tip number 6. People understand at their level of perception. So our perceptual set involves our attitudes, our beliefs, and values about the world. And I'm sure we've all heard the phrase, looking at the world through rose-colored glasses, because we all see things through our own lens. And this is all developed through mediated images and communication. So our experiences ultimately form our mental expectations of what is happening and what is going going to happen. So it's really important to know perception is reality, and physicians by nature are not trained to think like coders. So you really have to meet people at their level. And if they're not getting it, that's okay. You just have to understand that it's not personal, because people understand at their own level of perception. Pro tip number 7, pick your battles. No one is perfect, and physicians have a lot of competing interests. So there's going to be some things that you have to let go. So for example, if your physician is not documenting in a certain section of the note, but they are actually documenting, so that's something you can let go. But there's going to be things that you can't let go. So for example, timely signatures. Physicians are notorious about not signing off and completing their notes. And it's not that they want to be in this position, it's that they never have enough time to do all of the tasks that are required. So timely signatures is something we can't bend on. It absolutely has to be done, because you can't bill for things that don't have signatures. And also, lack of clinical documentation. This is something that we can't bend on. We have to require thorough, robust clinical documentation. This is another example of an area we can't really bend on. So you have to pick your battles and just know that no one is perfect and everyone sees things through their own lens. Pro tip number 8, make it quick and make it count. So you really have to keep it high level. You don't want to talk about basics. You want to keep it high level. And keep in mind, as you're developing your content, you should not be trying to educate a physician about the anatomy and physiology or the coding guidelines associated with codes, because they don't care. You just need to break it down for them in a way that they need to understand what you need to see in their documentation. They don't need the who, what, when, where, and why. So you have to really keep it high level, and don't start with information overload where you're just load and boring them with these insignificant details. You really have to make it count. The best way to do this is with one pagers or cheat sheets, coding tools. You don't want to send them 2-page long emails or really think that they're going to spend an hour doing a webinar. It's not realistic in this day and age. You got to be ready. You got to make it quick, and you got to make it count. Pro tip number 9, accommodate their needs. So where do they communicate best? Do they like to text? Are they a phone call person? Do they like to do Zoom? Rarely with physicians is it email, because a lot of times they're just not checking their email. They're not in a position where they can really check email. And email gets very noisy, especially for physicians. They're copied on a million emails. So the thought of actually going in their inbox is overwhelming. So you have to get creative and think about where you can get the most effective communication with the physician. You also have to be flexible in your expectations, especially with their schedule. Sometimes they run late. Sometimes their case goes over. Sometimes you have to meet with them at 6 o'clock in the morning. Sometimes you have to meet with them at 7 o'clock at night. You have to be flexible and adaptable to their needs. Things often are not going to go as you had planned. So if you're scheduled to meet with the physician for an hour and they show up and you have 20 minutes to do what you had planned to review in an hour, you really have to be able to think quick on your feet and be effective. So flexibility is going to be key, and just accommodate their needs. Pro tip number 10, food can be enticing. So physicians are often very busy and don't have a chance to stop and eat lunch or breakfast. They're constantly seeing patients and being pulled in a million different directions. So if you can involve food with your meeting, maybe booking the meeting over lunch or actually bringing in lunch, you're going to be very effective in your meeting, because the physician's going to appreciate it. Everyone loves food. You'll likely get their attention a lot more than if they're sitting there hungry and thinking about their next meal. So always incorporate food if you're able. So grab a pen and paper to summarize my top 10 pro tips for mastering physician communication. Number 1, always start the conversation off on a positive note. Number 2, practice empathy. Number 3, understand the physician compensation structure in the organization. Number 4, your approach is everything. Number 5, exude confidence. Number 6, people understand at their level of perception. Number 7, pick your battles. Number 8, make it quick and make it count. Number 9, accommodate their needs. Number 10, food can be enticing. So it's time for this week's coding pro tip, and it's brought to you by Project Resume. When is the last time you had your resume updated? Your resume is literally your entry ticket to that next great opportunity. Project Resume will design a customized ATS-friendly resume to demonstrate your unique skills and experience. And even better, it's written by coders for coders. Make that investment in yourself today and visit projectresume.net and mention my code ALPHACODING for special pricing. If you have a coding-related question and would like it to be featured in one of our coding pro tips, please reach out to me on LinkedIn, Facebook, Instagram, or YouTube. So this week's coding pro tip comes to us from Missouri. Hi, Toni. Can you tell us about your experience with physical therapy coding? I'm new to the specialty and was hoping for some helpful tips. Absolutely. So I've worked with PT for a long time, and I'll tell you, one of the best places to check for documentation is the activity logs. Those will typically have all of the exercise activity, the stretches, and the time. Time is a critical component, and the majority of the codes are based on time. So you have to understand the time-based rules and the rule of eights, having minimum 8 minutes of documentation for each exercise and each area is absolutely critical. So definitely do some research on the rule of eights, and the clinical documentation that's required for each of the services is very specific. And keep in mind the PT eval codes have changed significantly in the last couple of years. So you really want to do your homework on what constitutes moderate versus high complexity. I hope that points you in the right direction. Please remember to hit that subscribe button now so you never miss another episode. Also, be sure to drop us a rating and review on iTunes. We really appreciate your support. So this concludes today's episode. Until next week, thank you for listening to the Alpha Coding Podcast. We'll see you next Monday.
For more information about medical coding and billing pro tips, including how to hire alpha coding experts, follow us on LinkedIn, Instagram, Facebook, YouTube, or visit our website at www.alphacodingexperts.com.